Come here, boy. There's a price to pay. Since the Lord's gonna tell them don't touch it or don't eat it, and they do it, there's a price to pay. If we disobey God, there's a price to pay.
Yeah.
They are talking to the Word, and the Word tells them to shut up, and they don't do it. But it doesn't take the miracle back.
All right.
It's in the text.
All right.
See, that was your moment to shout. Because every one of us has come to God and asked God for something, and God did more for us than we deserve. He gave us more than we could imagine, and then we disobeyed him. We were disobedient, and he didn't take it back.
All right. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
He let us keep the blessing, and then forgave us for our disobedience.
Thank you, Lord.
All of us have been disobedient. But God kept blessing us. God kept keeping us. God kept doing for us. God kept giving us more than we deserved, even though we messed up.
All right.
And then, but it doesn't. But this is why it's a setup. Because they went out and they said, because they went out talking and telling, they told other people, and other people were able to come. Because in the next verse it says, when they went out talking, after they went out, they brought a dumb man in who couldn't speak.
Right.
And Jesus healed him.
All right.
So every now and then, because God has been good to you, you ought to be prepared to tell somebody just how good he's been. That's why every one of us should have a testimony that God has been good to us, because every one of us and every one of us in here has had a week where we didn't fall short of God's glory. But God kept on waking us up, keep on giving us what we need day by day. And even though we failed, he provided us new grace and new mercy every day. And so we ought to be ready to go out and tell somebody on the outside a reason why they need to come on the inside so they can get some too.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to upset anybody, but if you haven't, there's going to come a day when you have to follow God in the dark.
Right.
But if you trust him, you keep your hand in his hand, when you come on the other side, he'll give you more than you deserve.
Amen.
He'll treat you better than you expect.
Amen.
All it is a test. When the test is over, it's celebration time.
Mm-hmm.
When the test is over and you pass the test, you don't have to deal with that no more. Mm-hmm. If you pass the test, you move on to the next thing. The Bible says you move on up a little higher.
Yeah.
And then your only job after you pass the test is tell somebody else how you got over.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, I got it.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to follow Jesus in the dark. I wish I could tell you it's always going to be sitting in the shade sipping lemonade. And every day is going to be a bright day. But now there will come a time, but there will come a day when every day is a bright sunshine day.
Mm-hmm.
As long as we're on this side of the Jordan, some days we're going to walk and follow Jesus in the dark. Some days we're going to be following the light but can't see light. But as long as we keep doing what he told us to do, and we remember that every test is an open book test, that everything will be all right.
Yeah.
And when we come out on the other side, we need to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
So that if they're in darkness, they won't fail the test.
Mm-mm.
We did snapshot testing Friday. I was texting my wife and I said, she was asking me how it was going. I said, oh, it's just me and 14 sixth graders locked in a room together for 4.5 hours. You know, not too bad. But when the test was over, unfortunately, not everybody passed. However, there's a retake this coming week. And if you don't want to retake the test you're in right now, open the book. Get the cliff notes.
All right.
So that you can pass it. Because if you don't pass it, you'll have to take it again.
Yeah.
Because that's how it works. You got to keep taking the test until you pass the test. Mm-hmm. And then after you pass the test, you can move on to something else. The reason why we see the craziness we see in the communities today is because a whole lot of people are walking around in the dark.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But the real issue is they don't have anybody in their life with vision.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody that can point them in the right road so they can get to Jesus. But if they can get to Jesus and get in the house,
yeah,
he'll have a conversation with them and blow their mind. And then make everything all right.
Yeah.
And then they'll have what they need to go tell somebody else about the same Jesus who did the same thing for them.
Yeah.
As we stand all over the room, I invite you as you go throughout this week to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
And tell them how in your opportunities and moments of life, you were able to follow Jesus in the dark.